Dr. Stacy Ripke, and for today's 3-Minute Mondays, we're going to share all about our college's academic societies. When students enter NYU Dentistry, they're placed in one of 14 academic societies, and these are smaller group learning communities that support students and encourage collaboration and partnership from the moment students enter through graduation and beyond. So come along with us.
At the NYU College of Dentistry, academic societies are an integral part of our students' lives. These societies are named after individuals who have made groundbreaking advances in dentistry, public health, or have had the opportunity to break the ceiling for others to follow. Students who have chosen a profession need to develop that profession by engaging with others with the same mindset. Our academic societies provide an arena where students can learn humility, experience collegiality, and strive to be the very, very best they can in an environment that's nurturing and also provides them with a network of like-minded individuals.
Membership to these societies offers opportunities in leadership and professional development. It's about belonging to a professional legacy and moving the profession forward for the betterment and the well-being of the patients that we serve. There's a transition from year one to year four. Where students will come in, they're a little bit scared, unsure of what they're doing, but to see that evolution and that growth and that bonding that occurs between their senior mentors from year one to year four until they get to the graduation stage is a wonderful moment.
The best part about senior mentorship is the relationships you make with individual students. Best part of the academic society, it's a 4-year continuum of relationships, both in their existing class, the classes before them, and the classes that come after them.
I think being part of academic societies is really cool because it gives us both a tie to history and also a legacy to live up to. So I think as we continue throughout our dental school career and also into the professional future that we have, we kind of have something to aspire to.
Yes, and our senior mentor organizes events to show us that he really cares, like breakfasts spontaneously, and he also really tries to get to know us at a personal level.
I love seeing our D1s grow. When I meet them at orientation, some of them have never even been to New York before, ever. It's their first time here. But D4 and the end of D4 and graduation, they're my colleagues. They're ready to join me. We're ready to have them join us in our field. It's just so wonderful to see them grow.
Being part of an academic society means that we're all interconnected, meaning that we get to talk to our peer mentor, our peer tutor, and our academic advisor, and they all work with our senior mentor, meaning that we're always interconnected and always supported.
I also want to talk about the D1 to D4 collaboration that we have throughout the years, and just such a supportive environment is really, really something that is felt by the patients, the positivity, the enthusiasm, all that.
I'm so proud to say that I'm a part of the Jones Society. Not only are we a community, but we are truly a family. Everyone loves to help one another, and we get along beautifully.
It's like having a group of best friends that are there with you from the first day to the last and forever.
So 20 years down the road, when they come back for a reunion, they all be different people with many new adventures. But they will be always be united as a society and overjoyed to see all the people who they spend 4 years of their life together.
It's been wonderful to hear from students and faculty on the ways in which academic societies are truly so embedded in the entire student experience and are so core to our community here at NYU Dentistry. That's it for today's 3-Minute Mondays, and I'll see you next week.